The Minister of State for Transport, Fred Byabukama, says there is rampant fraud in third-party motor insurance. He was appearing before the Parliamentary Committee on Health. Byabukama remarked that it was discovered over 80% of COMESA stickers were forged. He accuses insurance companies of imposing tedious conditions and arguments to frustrate accident victims from claiming compensation, while other insurance companies tend to over-centralize their services.
It was discovered that almost 80% of the COMESA stickers were forged. Insurance claim officers in bid to save costs for their companies import all manner of clothes and arguments that will deny the victims their right to claim. Failure to decentralize settlement of claims or insurance claims are settled at head offices, not up country branches.
Sande Protazio, the Director of Strategy and Market Development in the Insurance Regulatory Authority of Uganda, told the committee that claims of motor third-party insurance by accident victims have remained too low due to lack of awareness and low limits of payments.
From our studies, what we have established as the probable causes of low claims, why many people are not claiming, and I will mention what we have done so far. One is awareness. And two, for those who have claimed and they have said that insurers have not paid, actually a majority of them are not third parties. They claim when the vehicle has been knocked, they claim compensation, but the Third Party Act does not extend to property damage. That should actually have been covered under Motor Comprehensive.
The Motor Third Party Insurance Act of 1998 provides that if the same accident has many claimants on aggregate, the insurance company can only pay up to 10 million shillings per accident, while in cases of few victims, each victim is paid not more than 1 million shillings. The Insurance Regulatory Authority has called for amendment of the law to increase payments. Motor third-party insurance is a mandatory requirement that a vehicle should have before it gets on the road. But according to Insurance Regulatory Authority, only 700,000 vehicles are currently insured out of 1.8 million motor vehicles in Uganda due to gaps in the law that excludes government vehicles from mandatory third-party insurance.
To expand the scope of cover to also cover property damage, third-party property damage. So we are making it a mini motor comprehensive insurance so that if you are driving and they knock you, there is some cover for your vehicle as well.
However, MPs raised concerns over lengthy processes of claiming for third-party insurance, which frustrates claimants to give up.
But also, there are civil society groups, people who have failed to get, I think I bumped into some of them, and they are so bitter with the insurance companies. People who have been maimed, people who have helped people chase for a million shillings. It has taken people a year. You know, somebody is in Kabale, coming here, police statements. You find you've put 3 million shillings to get a claim of 1 million shillings. So we need to listen to these groups, and they have a lot to tell us.
The minister just stated that we have a number of certificates, motor third-party certificates, which are actually forged. Most other Western countries now are going digital in terms of actually finding out whether anything is genuine or not, without even stopping the vehicle.
According to Uganda Police annual crime report of 2022, 35% of the people who died in road crashes were pedestrians, 14% were passengers in motor vehicles, while 43% were motorists and passengers on motorcycles. The Minister of Health demands that 10% of the motor third-party insurance collection and revenue accrued from traffic offences to be collected to the health sector.
We make our request, we request that an allocation of about 10% for the start of third-party motor vehicle fees and traffic offences fees be allocated to the health sector in response to the increasing road traffic crashes in country.
According to the Ministry of Finance, 15.1 billion shillings was collected in the year 2022 from third-party insurance. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.